In the past, you've said that you thought that there's a magic age of 30 with the franchise, and kind of they start to phase out players as they get older. Do you think that had anything to do with James Harrison's departure, and what are your thoughts on him heading to New England?
You know, I believe that, you know, at the end of the day, James is a football player, and he wants to play. Obviously, he was looked at as an insurance type of situation for the Steelers. They drafted a first-round outside linebacker, so you kind of knew that his opportunities were going to be limited. He wanted to play more, of course, he would. I mean, obviously, the career that he's had, he wants to be on the field. So you knew that it was going to come to a head at some point. Unfortunately, he made a decision to go to New England. That was probably the one place of any place that he had gone to that would create this type of issue, because, you know, obviously the Patriots are the team that the Steelers have struggled to beat.
Well, you know this fan base well, though. How will he be remembered by Steelers fans, and can he make amends with that organization?
You know what? I believe he can make amends if the Steelers beat the Patriots this year.
All right.
If the Patriots beat the Steelers, I think he'll go down as one of those guys that made a bad decision late in his career. But ultimately, I think, you know, when you look back at his career, as a Pittsburgh Steeler, it was an incredible career that he had. So hopefully it won't be tainted by this move. Obviously, it's a latter part of his career. So hopefully people remember the great part of his career in Pittsburgh.
To that point on beating the Patriots, the NFC feels more wide open. Of course, anything can happen, but it does sort of seem like there's a collision course between the Patriots and the Steelers. Do you believe the Patriots just have their number, or can Pittsburgh beat them?
Well, I think historically the Steelers had the wrong type of defense to really defend the Patriots and Tom Brady in particular, because they were more of a zone defense. They had the fire zones and that type of thing, where the Patriots and Bill Belichick and that brain trust, they had a great understanding of how the defense worked. And so they gave Tom Brady all the tools necessary to beat the Steelers year in and year out. And so I think now the Steelers have had to change their philosophy in terms of how you attack Tom Brady. So now you see more man-to-man defenses. And I think they've been able to close the gap. You go back to the championship game last year, and they got blew out of that game, where – in the regular season, they lost a close game that really went down to the last play of the game. And so that tells you that the Steelers' defense, in terms of how they're attacking Tom Brady, is much better at it. And I think it's going to be a close game if they see each other, you know, in the playoffs.